Well, today we're talking about base layering, and a lot of people think that, you know, they can go out and buy a big, thick, heavy coat, and you know, they'll be warm no matter what. No, well, it's not the case. A lot of people will dress with cotton as a base, and it's the worst thing you can do in the wintertime because it absorbs moisture, it doesn't dry quickly, and it's the equivalent of wrapping yourself with a wet towel. Wool's one of the best on the market right now for as far as breathability, low odor retention, and that sort of thing. But you can go into lower price points with a lot of the synthetics that are out there right now. You can even get base layer underwear available for men and women, and this is all synthetic. It's really, really easy to wash. It comes antimicrobial, so there's low odors. And the synthetics will have a great form-fitting fit, which is what you want when you're looking at wicking moisture from your body. You don't want anything that hang. Synthetics, anything that you're going to be fast-paced, cross-country skiing, snowshoeing, any really winter activities where it's a fast activity. It's not something you probably wouldn't want to wear a lot of synthetics if you're ice fishing. The big thing too with insulation is, and base layering, is the thicker it is, the longer it takes to wick. So if you can take up any insulation you've got that you use a base layer and just hold it up to the light, if you can see through it rather readily, great. That just means the moisture will move that through it that much faster. Now this is a lightweight top. You'd wear this directly against your skin. It's a Lycra or spandex mix. You can also wear wool directly against your skin. And from there you'd be going on to an additional layer. This is what's considered just basically like a layer sweater. So it's got a full frontal zip, so it is easy to take off if need be. But it does provide you that extra warmth because it is a lot thicker. You want to do layering from top to bottom, and you can get sock layers. They're really generally quite thin. You can wear them as a base sock. Now you wouldn't want to wear a cotton sock over top underneath a thick sock. It's going to be completely against what that sock's supposed to do, and you're just going to freeze in the end anyway. You can also get glove liners for your gloves, so you actually have a wicking layer before the actual insulation of the glove. When you've done your research with base layers, now people have to choose for what activity they're using their outerwear for, whether it's they need it to be waterproof, windproof, or they just need a lot of bulky insulation. Now you can go into something like this. This is what's considered a soft shell. Now this would work great for high active skiing, maybe not so much tobogganing, but skiing, snowshoeing, anything like that. If you're going more towards ice fishing, you may want to consider something more along the lines of a down parka, something that's going to provide you more insulation because you're not necessarily moving a whole lot.